Hi friends, welcome back to Curious With. I am Dr. Mohsina. In today's video, we will discuss a small topic, but it is an important topic. It is regarding a reabsorption defect in kidneys. It is Fanconi syndrome. So let's see the details of Fanconi syndrome. Fanconi syndrome is a generalized proximal tubular reabsorptive defect resulting in excessive loss of many solutes in urine. So there is defective reabsorption in the proximal tubules. So this is a picture of normal renal physiology. You can see different parts of nephron here. Proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, distal convoluted tubules and collecting duct. You can see the reabsorption happening in different parts of the nephron. Just pause the video and see which molecules are absorbed in which locations of the nephron. So in this condition, the Fanconi syndrome, the proximal tubular reabsorption is affected. It has been reported as an acquired condition in dogs. Chicken jerky treat ingestion, gentamicin nephrotoxicosis and an idiopathic form. This is a picture of chicken jerky treat ingestion. So there was increased incidence of Fanconi syndrome in the dogs fed with chicken jerky treats. So these are some reports regarding the increased cases of this disease in dogs which are fed with chicken jerky treat. So there is an acquired form and there is a heritable form in a variety of breeds, but most notably in Basenji's, in which it develops gradually in adults of both sexes. So Basenji's are the most commonly affected breed affected with heritable form of Fanconi syndrome. As previously mentioned, the Basenji seems to be the breed most at risk of inheriting the disorder, but instances of idiopathic Fanconi syndrome has occurred in other breeds too, although a lot less frequently, and this includes the following breeds. There is an excessive urinary loss of glucose, sodium, potassium, phosphorus, uric acid, bicarbonate, albumin and amino acids in this condition due to the defective reabsorption. Blood glucose concentrations are normal and serum electrolytes are normal early in the disease, but phosphatemia, hypokalemia and metabolic acidosis are seen in the later stages of the disease. Coming to the clinical signs, the most important clinical signs are polydipsia, polyuria and weight loss. Signs of uremia may be present if the animal is in stage 3 or 4 chronic kidney disease. Now let's see the diagnosis of Fanconi syndrome. Diagnosis is based on documentation of increased urinary fractional excretion of glucose, sodium, potassium, phosphorus and bicarbonate in the presence of normal plasma concentrations. Hypoalbuminuria is likely to be present because the proximal tubule normally reabsorbs the small amount of albumin that traverses the glomerular filtration barrier. So hypoalbuminuria is likely to be present in this condition. So these are some renal ultrasonographic images. One is a sagittal view of left kidney of a dog, of two dogs, dog one and dog two. And both dogs show increased echogenicity of bilateral corticomedullary junction and dilated renal pelvis of the left kidney. Note the hyperechoic medullary region of the kidney. Then coming to the differential diagnosis. This disease should be differentially diagnosed from simple renal glucosuria and chronic kidney disease from other causes. The microscopic renal changes in the heritable form are not remarkable in the early stages, but progress to non-specific findings characteristic of chronic kidney disease. A genetic marker has been developed. A treatment regimen to reverse the tubular defect has not been described. The histologic appearance of the acquired forms of Fanconi syndrome vary depending on the cause. So this is the histological examination of age-matched controlled kidney ANC and affected kidney. Hematocellin and eosin staining in A and B, and periodic acid shift staining in the other two. There is cytonuclear debris from tubular cells observed in the lumen of the convoluted tubules here. And coming to the treatment, oral supplementation of sodium chloride 5 to 10 milligram per kilogram per day per oral, potassium 10 to 30 milligram per kilogram per day per oral, and alkali sodium bicarbonate 10 to 30 milligram per kilogram per day is indicated if the corresponding serum concentration is low. And dogs with acute or chronic kidney disease should be treated symptomatically as appropriate. The heritable disease is slowly progressive despite therapy and usually results in death from uremia. So that's all about Fanconi syndrome. You have to just memorize the breed affected, that is Basinges, and the location of the nephron affected with this disorder, and the common clinical signs and the diagnostic techniques. So if the video is informative, please like it and share it with your friends and comment your suggestions. If you are new to this channel and not subscribed yet, please subscribe and click the notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a video. See you soon with another video. Thank you.